Welcome back. Please subscribe to this channel, The Globetrotter, to know when we post the next video. Uruguay is a country in South America. It borders Argentina, Brazil, the Atlantic Ocean, and Rio de la Plata River. I was privileged to visit this country as a Rotary scholar and enjoyed some pleasant time with lovely, friendly, and warm people from this country. The capital is Montevideo, where we stayed for a week before moving to countryside for another 4 weeks. General Artigas, or General Artigas, was the founding father of Uruguay, and his statues are seen everywhere. Montevideo has a long rambla or promenade along the river bank. The river is very wide here, nearer to the ocean, so it appears to be a sea. It's a pleasant walk along the rambla, especially earlier in the morning when you see lovely shades of light. We visited a museum of phones, and after that the Zorisha Museum, named after another local hero. Although some people are religious, Uruguay is an atheist country. And we even visited a school for grooming models and clicked a pic with future models. We went to Colonia del Sacramento from Montevideo, a town that was transferred between Spain and Portugal a dozen times, sometimes due to battles, sometimes due to weddings, sometimes due to treaties. It is now a World Heritage Site declared by UNESCO. It had a vintage car rally when we were there. Colonia has even got a Colosseum. Ancorena National Park is a park and second home of Uruguayan president. This botanical garden has more than 200 species of trees from all the continents. It has a 75 meter tall tower that provides a great view. On a clear day, one can even see buildings of Buenos Aires in Argentina. I was in a team on this Rotary program and we bonded really well. Amol, Asim and Monica are my friends for life now. We visited a bizarre museum of 7,000 pencils, some 28,000 keychains, 2,000 odd perfume bottles, etc. It is featured in the Guinness Book of World Records. Here is a building resembling an eagle. Originally, it simulated the deck of a ship emerging from the earth, but later it became an eagle. This is made by hand entirely without the foundation and traditional structural reinforcement, and that makes it an admirable construction. We attended the Rotary District Conference in Pando and met the Vice President of Uruguay. I was hosted by Alfredo's family for some days and I tried to cook some dishes for my hosts. I tried traditional drink mate but could not cultivate the taste. It has a pungent taste like a cross between green tea and coffee with a hint of tobacco. It is common to see people walking around the streets carrying a mate and a thermos to refill. Next up are some pictures of homes in Uruguay. These are large with abundant space in and outside the homes. The roofs have a slope for snow to slide down during winter. Uruguay ranks first in South America in democracy, peace, e-governance, press freedom, absence of terrorism and prosperity. It contributes more troops to United Nations peacekeeping missions than any other country on a per capita basis. Here we are in a city called 33, meaning 33, which refers to 33 national heroes who established the independence of Uruguay. Coincidentally, the city is located near the 33 degrees south line of latitude, making the name doubly appropriate. Quebrada de los Cuervos, which means Valley of the Crows, is an important naturally protected area. It is inhabited by several endangered species. We visited many Rotary clubs in Uruguay and exchanged our club flags and made a local lady Sylvia wear Indian sari. She looks as if she's Indian, isn't it? Haciendas in Uruguay are estates where the owners have plantations. The word is derived from the Spanish word hacer or hacer, which means to make. So these were large estates where the owners had businesses. In Uruguay, they mainly raise farm animals for meat production. The sizes are typically huge, with the average being 250 hectares or 625 acres. The largest farm is 50,000 hectares or 125,000 acres. The owners have gauchos or horse riders managing the hacienda. The children of owners are encouraged to become veterinary doctor or agriculturist. Uruguay has only 3.5 million people, but it has 12 million cows and 12 million sheep. In the next video, we will see Uruguay along the Atlantic coast. Please subscribe to this channel to know when I post that.